So by the time Eisenhower is president, there is a huge new flow of cash into defense industries.
He was the first to acknowledge that a permanent military establishment would be required during this period, but that unless we could find some kind of breakthrough, that in fact it would end up creating a terrible cost.
The cost of one modern heavy bomber is this: a modern brick school in more than 30 cities.
It is two electric power plants, each serving a town of 60,000 population. It is two fine, fully equipped hospitals.
We pay for a single fighter plane with a 500,000 bushels of wheat.
We pay for a single destroyer with new homes that could have housed more than 8,000 people.
This is not a way of life at all, in any true sense. Under the cloud of threatening war, it is humanity hanging from a cross of iron.
My father, as president, had strong guiding principles. He used to say, modern weapons take food from the hungry and shelter from the homeless. And so he was fighting with the Pentagon all the time for asking for too much and Congress for giving it to him.
I don't think we should pay 1 cent for defense more than we have to.
Well, Eisenhower saw us starting to build program after program that was just out of control. And his own ability to shape national security policy was being hemmed in by these forces he couldn't control, and he was the president.
On at least one occasion, Eisenhower was heard to say by those in the room, "God help this country when somebody sits at this desk who doesn't know as much about the military as I do."
My fellow Americans, this evening, I come to you with a message of leave-taking and farewell, and to share a few final thoughts with you, my countrymen. We have been compelled to create a permanent armaments industry of vast proportions. 3.5 million men and women are directly engaged in the defense establishment. The total influence, economic, political, even spiritual, is felt in every city, every state house, every office of the federal government. We recognize the imperative need for this development, yet we must not fail to comprehend its grave implications. In the councils of government, we must guard against the acquisition of unwarranted influence, whether sought or unsought, by the military-industrial complex. The potential for the disastrous rise of misplaced power exists and will persist.
You have to realize this is one of the great presidents, great military leaders. On his way out the door, at the end of his second term, he says, by the way, watch out for the military-industrial complex.
People know that he invented the phrase military-industrial complex, but very rarely do you see the whole thing and realize how utterly strident his warning was. I think it's one of the most profound statements ever made by an American president.
We must never let the weight of this combination endanger our liberties or democratic processes.